lot of folks who are in the ocean suffer from dry eyes. What are some of the things that could be contributing to this problem, and what can help? Ophthalmologist Dr. Melanie Tentesira of the Queen's Medical Center joining us this morning for our Ask a Specialist segment. Good morning to you, Doctor.
Good morning.
A lot of folks suffer from this, how is a diagnosis made? What is dry eye?
Dry eye, well, it can be many different things because we do have various layers that contribute to the tears. So we can have not enough water, and we could also have abnormalities in the other two layers of the tear film. Diagnosis is usually made by asking questions about the symptoms, examining the eyes, and doing various testing.
Now, you talk about the tear film, and we have an image here at home. I didn't know there are that many layers on our eyeball. Is that the right word,
of course,
eyeball?
Yes.
What are folks seeing at home here?
Okay, they're seeing that there's an aqueous layer, and that would be the fluid, mm-hmm. and that carries nutrients and oxygen to the surface of the eye. Mucus layer is what causes the tear film to actually adhere to the eye in a smooth film so that we can see. If it breaks up into little droplets, then it causes irregularity and it causes blurry vision, which is one of the symptoms of dry eye. Many people don't know that. And then we have a lipid layer, oil layer. And the oil layer, if it breaks up or is not enough of the oils, then we have rapid evaporation. And even if we have enough aqueous or water, then our eyes will feel dry because it's evaporating really quickly.
So what's triggering this? What's some of the risk factors that we are doing?
Risk factors.
Because we are doing it, right?
Of course, yeah. Yes, we have a lot of it. The biggest one these days, is screen time. Mm. All of us are on our phones all the time, and studies have shown that we blink much less frequently when we're looking at our screens. Huh. So if we're on our phones, computers, any other devices, our blink rate goes down, our tears evaporate more quickly, and we're going to be drier. Air conditioning, contact lenses, getting older, we're all getting older, and so those are things that are going to cause this problem to surface.
Oh, video screen, the big culprit. Okay,
yes.
So we talk about this, now we talk about treatment.
Yes.
And there are different types of treatments.
Yes, definitely. Yeah. The easiest one, of course, if we have just very mild problems, artificial tears. Once we're going more than a couple times a week with artificial tears,
not good.
Yeah, then we go ahead and step it up. We can use nutritional supplements. That's mostly for problems with the lipid layer because we use some omega-3s and that helps with lipids. Restasis, that's a drop that's used morning and night that helps produce more tears, reduces inflammation. We do warm compresses. That's going to help mostly with the lipid layer. And so we can also use a combination of any or all of those. And the main thing is you don't have to suffer. Please come in and let us check you out and see what we can do to help you.
Yeah, there are other things. You can use drops and pills as well. And
exactly.
I know a lot of folks who have tried steroids and they work.
They do. That's mostly to reduce the inflammation, and that's usually a temporary measure. Once we get you going on the other things, then usually we can start to taper and not use anti-inflammatories chronically.
Out of 10 people, who suffers from dry eyes? I mean, if you were to do numbers.
Yes. I would say about probably 3 to 4 out of 10.
It's
a very common problem.
All right. If you want to learn more about dry eye syndrome, you can call Dr. Tentesira at 591. We'll put the number on the screen, 9111. Perfect number to call, by the way. 911.
Yes.
And real quick, I got to wrap this up, but I use drops that make it feel cool. Not
yes.
good.
Well, it's good for temporary relief, of course. You know, we want you to be comfortable, but if you're using them all the time, probably you need to do something else.
Yeah, moderation.
Right.
Thank you very
much. Exactly. You're welcome.